My name's Harold Hungerford. I'm a professor emeritus at Southern Illinois University, Carbondale, Illinois, and I've been retired for longer than I can think.
I'm Trudy Volk. I'm also a retired professor at SIUC, Southern Illinois University, Carbondale. Both Harold and I came from a formal education background and worked in the area of formal education all our life. So our real focus on environmental ed has been where it fits, how it fits, what it can do within formal education, mostly in the K-12 arena. The events, actually, we said that we thought shaped the field were the Tbilisi conference with its objectives. I think Harold's goals for curriculum development, the establishment of the Office of Environmental Education and EPA, and then Boris Simmons' work with the National Guidelines for Excellence. I see the Tbilisi objectives, and they were an attractive and tight group. It looked comprehensive. We talk about awareness and sensitivity to the environment, knowledge and understanding of the environment and its challenges, attitudes of concern, skills to identify and help resolve challenges, and then participation. So it is a nice continuum. Harold and Ben Payton and Rick recognizing how do we get from here to the classroom, worked on the goals for curriculum development. At that same time, we were working on an instructional model called Investigating and Evaluating Environmental Issues and Actions and trying it out in classrooms and getting a lot of feedback, et cetera. So we were able to start getting a bigger picture of this. I think that the guidelines for excellence then is a direct follow from that because it more in a more itemized fashion and working with a large group of educators, Bora was able to tease down standards or the guidelines, but certainly identifiers of things that could be done, things that should be done at the various grade levels to move students toward a more environmentally positive and participatory role in the world.
Students can be autonomous learners once they've got the skills in order to do it. And I think that's probably the most important thing in my mind in environmental education, to give the kids the skills that they need to investigate and evaluate issues and then make responsible citizenship decisions about what we ought to do about those issues. One anecdote that I just love is I walked into a classroom in Hawaii and the teacher was leaning up against a wall and she looked very, very bored. And I walked over to her and I said, Vicki, what's the problem? And she said, Harold, I'm bored. These kids don't need me anymore. She said, I don't know what to do as a teacher because they're autonomous. They're doing the work that they're supposed to be doing. And if they have a real problem, they'll come and talk to me. But otherwise, they just talk to themselves and each other. And I thought at the time, this is what I want. This is what I want to have happen.
One of the things that when we were talking of who influenced us, I reminded Harold of something he had written. He was very much influenced by John Dewey, and so was I. The American philosopher.
Right.
And what John Dewey thoroughly believed that was that school is not a preparation for life, but school is life. And we can't put off preparing students for life. Life is dealing with issues. What we tend to do is to say, oh, they're too young. They don't have to think about that. They're too young. And it goes all the way up until they're out of high school. And then we say, start thinking about it. Start voting responsibly. Start acting like a full citizen. When all along, we deprive them of any practice in doing that. And that practicing, that being a citizen, a fourth grader, a fifth grader, a sixth grader can look at issues, can think about them, can consider the sides of them, could find evidence for them, could make recommendations about how they're solved, and depending on the issue, can do some things as a citizen. There's some things they can't do yet. They can't vote, but there are things they can do. And that is not just a good approach to environmental education. That is a good approach to citizenship.
Yeah.